Hello everyone, I'm your host boss, Zombie. Welcome back to Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Let's go find this ship, shall we? So my ship wasn't here either. Vroom. You found a clue. You know the place? Some kind of thing called dowsing, vroom. That's amazing, Vweep. This time we'll definitely find my ship, Vweep. Ready to set sail, Vweep? To sea! Anchors away, vroom. Alright, so this part's kind of... not great. How are we going to search this whole huge sea? I have no choice but to ask you to do it for me, so get cracking, Vweep. There's a high probability the ship is currently hidden from our view, Vweep, but if we attack it, then we might just catch a glimpse of it. Zerp. Oh, it's over that way. Oh wait, I can just run these guys over. How does the map look here? Why was it so weirdly... Alright. Gotta get out of these rocks. Out. Is there no end to the rocks? I thought the rocks were only in this part. Okay, now we're getting back to, like, the shoals and stuff. Run you over! Run you over! So it looks like it's on the northern side of this reef. Dead ahead. It really is just straight ahead. Oh, here we go. Hey! Did you see it, Vweep? That's my ship room. We must pursue. And keep pounding with the cannon. Hey! Wow, I had... Again, the stuff I remember from this game, I had so much trouble with. How is this thing moving in the sand? And then coming back almost 10 years... No, not 10 years. This game came out 2011. So 6 years? 10 years. Coming back 6 years, it's... This game came out 2011, right? Not 2007. I'm having much less difficulty. Welcome to the sand ship. My favorite dungeon. That's not to say it's easy or even simple, but it's cool. Alright, so there's nothing. The path is pretty linear from what I remember. Until a certain point, at least. Oh, I can have a sit. I was gonna say, doesn't this heal? Thank you. I wonder in hero mode. I don't remember. I really don't remember my experience with hero mode, but do the stools heal you if you sit on them? Or do seats heal you? Of course there's Arrakas. Ooh, butterflies. Is it not? What the hell's going on here? That totally looked like it was... No. Is there... Weird. There must be a wall, because this is a dungeon. this wall. There we go. Yeah, there's usually a one wall per dungeon, so I'll have to keep that in mind when I come back this way. The ruby! Wait. Excuse me? Okay, that's just a dead-end hallway. Oh, it's Nehru's symbol. Are those electric keys? No, they're regular. There are no electric keys in this game. Alrighty. Hello? I like the light fixtures. Surprise! Listen, in the right places, bomb bowling is actually really fun. So what's going on? The chest. Like I said, the path is pretty linear. Alright, don't blow a lung. Ew. See, this is one of those, like... Wow, they don't even hurt when they bump into you. Everything is, like, too calm type situations, and then shit just is gonna break loose. It's kind of like the, Well, you know what? I might play that game, so maybe I won't actually spoil it if you haven't seen it, but there's a thing... Oh! There's a moment in Wind Waker kind of like that. Oh, I'm completely tired. Give me the rupees. Huh, they dropped jelly blobs? I figured they would have dropped, monster claws, considering that's their most prominent piece. Although I guess a claw is not the same as a pincer. More jelly. God, this is a good place to farm jelly if you needed it. But it's like one of the easiest resources to find, so I guess you would never really need it. Get out of here. Why is there a save statue here? Oh, there's gonna be a Beamos, okay. So in case you haven't pieced it together, like the rest of Lanayru Desert, this is gonna be a time-related puzzle to this dungeon, but this one takes it on a whole new level. It's a level with a whole new level? Master, please look. This large door here is sealed shut. This door must lead to an important room in the ship. Yeah, it's the end room. It's the room that we always see that has a big key on it. Speaking of keys... look at all that treasure. Where do I get that? How's it come from the floor below? Oh, bats and arrakas. Bats and arrakas. It's weird. This is an ancient ship made of wood. You wouldn't think it would hold up. So what do we got here? That's a prison cell. What's on the floor? Oh, it's the trick. It's the pattern I need to hit the things in. I think you need to get down there. You know, considering this thing has been sailing for hundreds or thousands, who knows how long, years, this light coating of dust and sand isn't that bad. Oh, I see. This is a jail cell because there's these little... When the time stone is fixed, or when is the time stone active, I guess, it's going to lock that door. Excuse me? trying to see what's on the floor. No, I don't want to talk to him. I know he doesn't work. Alright, so now... So I have them all revealed. And that's up. Is there a way to tell? So that's... So it goes down... How would I know the pattern, though? There's two downs, an up, and a right. So down, maybe down, right, up, down. Down, right, up, down. Nope. There must be a way of telling the order. That was the order I could see him from here, so maybe it's down, up. Is it clockwise, maybe? Down, up, down, right. Let's try that. Down, up, down, right. There we go. So it's kind of a counterclockwise. I don't know. Maybe there's something I was missing there, but that's what it seemed like. Treasure? Oh, just a key. Okay. Come to think of it, the last temple, last dungeon. Did it have key? I think it did have a key. Just didn't remember. Alright, so the key is not for that door. I did pass the key door on the way here. I wonder how early you fight the mini-boss in this one. Didn't I clear this away? Because like I said in the previous episodes, this is my favorite dungeon and my favorite mini-boss. Just gotta find the door with the key. Actually, I bet if I look at my map, there it is. Oh no, but that's not the right key. Let's see. The key there. Oh, right. Okay, so I think that is the mini boss. Why did that qualify for a scene change? Weird. What's going on in there? Whoops. God, they barely give you enough time to be able to do that. And then he has a busted lung. Ugh. Yeah, because we need to get onto the... What's the front bit called? The mast? Hello? Oh, you guys were fine. Link's eyes. So here's the goddess, so the goddess wall. Should be that way. I would explain the save statue. So yeah, I think this is the mini boss. Let's go. Ooh, this is. This is cool. Dum, dum. You basically have to beat him back to the, end of the mast. Oh, you lost your sword. That's okay. You've got another one. And that's getting closer. Oh, okay. So I have to... When he does that, I have to... Come on. Oh, now you lost your arm. That's alright, you have that thing. And that comes closer. Goodbye. Farewell, Skurvo! That was the pirate captain that sold the ship. Which raises the question, what could the boss possibly be on this one? It's not a humongous fight, but it's a cool idea. You duel someone on a mast. Master, that's synthetic life form. There's a 99% chance that it was the pirate described by the captain. I can't help but admire the tenacity it has displayed in staying alive and functional all these years. See, that's... Oh, excuse me. There's a way you can refight bosses, but there's no way to refight mini bosses. And I would actually love to refight him over and over again. He's cool. Blink. Oh yeah, and also I got the bow. I guess that's worth pointing out. Master, a report about the bow you have just obtained. Your bow's elasticity can propel arrows through the air with great force, allowing you to strike your targets from afar. To confirm the controls associated with your bow, raise your bow by pressing B and press 2. You can also shoot arrows to strike certain devices in order to activate them. Like that. I've confirmed that such a device exists on the deck. However, it will be difficult to target it from here, so I recommend you return to the deck. Goodbye, Skurvo. Oh, I didn't realize the sand ship had docked. God, this shield is really good. How fast it heals. Maybe that's what happens when you upgrade it. It doesn't just increase the general durability, but how fast it restores the durability. Alright, so yep, there it is. Boom. That reveals a time stone. See, the bow is the only thing I might consider having an upgraded item inventory for, the quiver. Because you use the bow a lot, and it's really good. I have important information for you. There's a 90% chance the object you see over there is a time shift stone. If you could deliver an impact to it by some means, it could have a significant effect on the ship. Yeah, no shit, Sherlock. So that's what's kind of cool about this ship. We just went through that part, and now watch what happens when we hit this. The whole ship goes back in time. What are you locking? Oh, now I can't actually activate the time shift stone again. And that's locked. Oh, these are regular Bokoblins. Wow, they don't take a lot of hits anymore. So I can't even leave the ship now. Look how cool, look at the pretty colors. I hear someone screaming at me. Wow, that is not centered. Can I hit him from here? What is happening? Well, he's dead. Up and up and up and up. God. Who's doing the whistling? Oh, God. Goodbye. Wow, this thing is not good at staying centered. Farewell! And what does this do? Oh, it's a winch. Okay. What's that? Oh, hello. Well, goodbye. Arrow's so useful. My problem is the shortage of arrows, which is why the quiver is totally worth it. Chugga chugga choo choo! The problem with this dungeon is there's kind of a lot of... Oh. Did I just screw myself? I didn't really need to do this, did I? Oh, there's still a dude up there. Hey there, buddy. Goodbye. There he goes. Yeah, this is... I don't think I had to do it this very second, but it's worth doing it just so I can have the time shift stone ready. Because you do have to do a bit of flip-flopping back and forth. Link, good job, Fweep. How did you get up here? Now the ship looks just like it used to, Fweep. That makes me so happy. Now I just need you to rescue my crew, Fweep. I'm pretty sure they're being held in the brig inside the ship, Zerg. I was there. Yep. It's still pretty dangerous here, so I'll just wait in the boat, Zerg. You can do it, Vroom. How did you get past the electric barrier? Coming down. Is there a point? Wait, this is the way I... Oh, this is how I came up. Screw that. Okay, so I opened... Is there anything else connecting on the deck? Nope. That was just to show me, I guess, that I will... need the, bow. And the time shift stone a lot. Save. You know, I probably should have made a backup save just so I could fight Skurvo over and over, but... Oh well. I'd say that's enough for this episode anyway, so thanks for joining me. Come back, I'll have the next stuff up real soon, but until then... Bye.